Tales from the Loop. From the Chronicles of the Order of Llamas, The Adventures of the Golly Llama. Away we go. What's up, llamas? Trying to get Fluffy-Dums to join the party. And maybe see if we can hook up with Supreme and Boucher. Scooby-Doo is Lit is playing. And there is Fluffy Lumps. How are you?
Excuse me, I'm good. How are you?
I'm okay. So, Supreme's in the lobby. Scooby-Doo is Lit is also playing. He's in a duo, but they just started. Boucher's down to the last three in his, well, squad's with three. It's got to be just him hanging out in the map, maybe. I don't know. I'm going to try and invite Supreme. Boucher's in a lobby with four. I know. Getting ready just to click on the duos. I like the shadow play emotes. Ready? Waiting to see if Greg picks up the stream and gives me feedback on whether I can be heard or not. Hello, hello, hello. Checking 1, 2, 3, checking 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, it sounds like you.
Yeah, it's supposed to. It's me.
Yeah, I just wanted to let you know, but I can hear you. I'm turning down the volume now.
Okay.
So let's go under this bridge. Is that all right with you?
Yeah.
There's another one right down below me if you want to do that one instead. You want to stay in the
I'm sorry, I'm multitasking again. I gotta get caught up.
Okay, I'm gonna go on this bridge instead, underneath this bridge instead.
Okay.
And then I'll go out towards the town there.
Well, I'm going to the cabin over here.
Okay, I'm coming.
I don't realize what time it is. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get my food ordered in time.
It's me driving.
It's okay.
I was trying to flip it and I couldn't. God, all I get here are SMGs.
Yeah, I was having that issue.
Where are you at? What you doing? Oh, you're upstairs.
As I said, I'm multitasking.
Multitasking. Okay.
God, I hope this is getting in time. Oh, go. We'll see. I hope they don't call me up and say, dude, we're closing in 5 minutes. You are not getting a turkey tongue. And then I'll be sad. I'll be like, but I can't drive and I can't walk because my legs are broken and I need help. Send me the foods.
Please.
Send me the foods. See that? Then I have to go out and make taquitos. I'm not feeling like taquitos. I'm feeling like a turkey tom with extra lettuce and bacon.
That sounds good.
A great big one. And there's Scooby-Doo now, sending an invite. He always sends the invites. He never just offers, asks to join. It's always like, join me. Damn it. Join us. We're in the middle of the map. At least let me gain the last 50 shields I need, and then I'll contemplate leaving.
Right?
At least I want to finish the challenge. Oh. This one, it doesn't really matter so much. I just lose points in my rank.
Wait, what is that?
What is what?
Oh, it's a llama.
It's a cursed llama. We have to get them. You have to get three of them. Come on,
okay,
you gotta go
I'm
this way.
We,
no, come.
Where
to
are
the,
you going?
I'm going to the cursed llama. We have to get it.
I'm going to the cursed llama too.
I'm looking at the one right here that's on the mini map. What one are you looking at? I don't see the one you're looking at. Your mini map wasn't that far off from mine. See? This one right here? He's waiting. He's like, come shoot me.
Okay, I see you.
Stop running. We're shooting you. Now pick up that power.
I'm coming.
Where did it drop one?
You picked it up already.
Well, no, it dropped one. But, ow, I can't. Oh, boy.
Damn it. I'm dead.
Going back to the lobby for a second. Yeah.
Okay.
So I can make sure that my food got in. No, I think I lost some points. Oops. Back to the lobby. Yeah.
Hey, I got some battle stars.
Yeah, dude, you invite and then you're just in a match again. Sigh.
Supreme's in the lobby.
Yeah, I said an invite. And... and since I'm stepping away for a moment, I don't care if anybody bops into the party because I'm going to be gone for a moment. They should have joined the first time.
True.
That's all I'm gonna say. So, hold on, because I'm hitting the be right back button.
Okay.
Hola, Greg. Hola. You out there? Sorry for the long intermission. I was waiting for my Jimmy John sandwich to arrive. The driver was just taking too many orders at once, I guess. Almost done with all the milestones.
If you have a utility meter like this on the side of your house, you could get paid to go solar for no money out of pocket. It costs... Is there a 30-minute countdown before the show starts? Well, we actually start live every day at 4 p.m. Eastern time, so this whole 30-minute countdown is a chance for YouTube and Rumble to send out their alerts and notifications, so we encourage you to gather up and hang out with everyone in the chat room. So every day at 4 p.m. Eastern time is when we do this show live. You can join us for the countdown if you like, or just set your clock and reminder that at 4 p.m. Eastern is when we go live. You can also make sure you subscribe and turn on that bell notification. So hopefully you will get a notification. What do you have to say about dictators of countries like Indonesia, who we sell weapons to, yet they are slaughtering people in East Timor? What do you have to say about Israel, who is slaughtering Palestinians, who impose martial law? What do you have to say about that? Those are our allies. Why do we sell weapons to these countries? Why do we support them? Why do we bomb Iraq when it commits similar problems?
Of things that are not right in this world, and the United States is trying. I really am surprised that people feel that it is necessary to defend the rights of Saddam Hussein, when what we ought to be thinking about is how to make sure that he does not use weapons of mass destruction.
There needs to be consistent application of U.S. foreign policy. We cannot support people who are committing the same violations because they are political allies. That is not acceptable. We cannot violate U.N. resolutions when it is convenient to us. You're not answering my question, Madam Albright.
Did you not when you were there?
Well, I had several jobs. One of my jobs was that of analyst. I also was an interrogator and indeed briefed the press when we, the CIA, wanted to circulate disinformation on a particular issue. Disinformation is not necessarily a lie, maybe a half-truth. And we would pick out a journalist. I would go do the briefing and hope that he would put the information in print.
What was your percentage of success?
We were pretty successful in planting information of a rather rarefied nature. For instance, if we wanted to get across to the American public that the North Vietnamese were building up their force structure in South Vietnam, I would go to a journalist and advise him that in the past 6 months,
apparently, Whoopi Goldberg is trying to apologize for her comments in regards to Jason Aldean's small town song. Nah, man, it's too late. It's too late. And I didn't even know that. She didn't even watch the video prior to commenting on it. She was just reading the lyrics, bro. Yeah, that threw me off. Before we get started, here's your disclaimer. Take a good look at it.
You know, when you're a certain age, use words that you know from when you were a kid or you remember saying, and that's what I did today, and I shouldn't have.
You've gone too far.
I don't understand how he could be that disconnected, how people around him didn't say to him, hey, listen, you know what? Maybe there's a better way to do this.
I know they're trying to say that this is not about race. It's about people getting together, acting right, acting like you got some common sense.
There's a lot wrong here.
In the realm of Hollywood, few figures are as iconic and influential as Whoopi Goldberg. Known for her extraordinary talent, boundless charisma, and groundbreaking achievements, she has risen to become a legendary figure in the entertainment industry. However, fame and success do not exempt celebrities from the complexities of legal battles, as demonstrated in a recent turn of events that left Whoopi Goldberg grappling with emotions like never before. As fans and followers of her illustrious career, the revelation of Whoopi's emotional struggles and raw anguish came as a stark reminder that even the most celebrated individuals endure profound challenges beyond the glitz and glamour of stardom. In a shocking twist that captured headlines and sparked public interest, Whoopi Goldberg found herself embroiled in a high-profile lawsuit that challenged not only her professional integrity, but also her well-being.
They take pictures, and then people say, what is that? Or you take a picture of Nelly.
The one and only Whoopi Goldberg has landed herself in yet another controversy, and this time it's looking serious. Buckle up as we dive into the nitty-gritty of how this beloved celebrity found herself in a sticky situation that could cost her big time. So the country singer Jason Aldean has been stirring up quite the storm with his latest song, Not in a Small Town.
Definitely.
And as fate would have it, this hot topic made its way to the set of The View.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Jason, and we're on the set of my brand new music video for Try That in a Small Town. Again, working with my favorite.
Where Whoopi and her fabulous co-hosts didn't hold back their opinions. Jason Aldean's most recent song, Try That in a Small Town, faced significant public criticism following the release of its music video. While the track was initially launched in May, it surged to the number 2 spot on the Billboard Hot 100 only after the music video's recent premiere. The video portrays protests and confrontations with the police, which contributed to its controversial nature. Despite the widespread scrutiny, the song remarkably defied the odds and managed to secure a high position on the music charts. As a testament to its popularity, the music video has already garnered over 22 million views. Now, we all know that Whoopi Goldberg is never one to shy away from speaking her mind, and boy, did she do just that. She slams Jason Aldean's left and right for the message conveyed in his song. It's safe to say that things got heated, and Whoopi made it crystal clear that she found the song's intentions questionable. But here's the kicker. It seems like Whoopi's fiery comments might have landed her in hot water. Rumor has it that Aldean and his team are seriously considering suing the legendary actress for the remarks she made on national television. And we're not talking chump change here. We're talking about a potential lawsuit that could have her facing the loss of
40 million,
she worked
right?
So hard to achieve.
I respect everything everyone is saying to me, and I you know, I don't want to fake apologize.
Following the recent release of the song, Whoopi Goldberg shared her thoughts, sparking even greater chaos and discussion surrounding the track. In a segment on The View, Whoopi Goldberg strongly criticized Jason Aldean's Try That in a Small Town. According to her, the portrayal of imagery related to the Black Lives Matter protests in the music video was unjustified and raised serious concerns. She stated, he's got folks from the Black Lives Matter movement, and he's talking about people taking care of each other. And I find it so interesting that it never occurred to Jason or the writers that that's what these folks were doing. They were taking care of the people in their town because they didn't like what they saw. Joy Behar and Sunny Hostin, her fellow co-hosts, vehemently criticized the song, branding it as deplorable and annoying.
Well, as a lawyer, when I put my legal hat on, I don't believe in censorship.
Right.
However, this man is from Macon, Georgia.
This triggered a significant wave of backlash from the fans. She continued, just like you talk about people taking care of
people back.
In small towns, we do the same thing in big towns. You just have to realize that when you make it about Black Lives Matter, people kind of say,
I sucked into YouTube. I saw you have returned. Welcome back. Gonna look into the Save the World stuff. We got garden gnomes and exterminations with a shotgun, which is almost done, so we're not gonna get rid of that. And we're just gonna go find some garden gnomes. Yep. Gonna go here. Stonewood. See. Really quick, just to confirm, you have Sunday night, correct? 6 o'clock? Doodly doo. Doodly doo. Doodly doo. Doo doo. Doo 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 doo. Doo doo. Where will I find the gnomes? In the suburbs? In the city. So I'm actually watching the chat, so if you reply, I'll see it. Ooh, can I? I can. We'll snap doodly dragons. If I can make it opaque at all. I'll leave that there for the moment because I can see it easier. Do 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 do. Well, I thought I could. Damn, where'd it go? Back where it was. Oh, man. Gonna try the burbs. Holy snapdragons. There's just 9 people in, but I don't think so. No, 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 no. There. It's a little better.
The further we travel from the storm shield, the worse the visibility gets. But I have a solution. Time to boost our visibility. You have 20 minutes to build 3 towers. You can build any 3 towers you want. I've marked the location of the towers on your map. You may want to collect resources before starting to build.
Yeah.
Thank you. Here we go. You know what to do.
Consider yourselves evicted!
5 minutes left. Towers, good job. You have time to keep building. Minutes before I have to pull you out. Thank you.
I got the gnomes done. Did not finish shooting them with the shotgun. Okay, I gotta cut this down because I'm falling asleep.